I've got my friend Mr. Trevor here. Woo! And I've got a very important question for him. Mr. Trevor, do you trust me?
No.
No? You don't trust me, Mr. Trevor?
No.
Not even a little bit?
Not even a little bit.
Oh my goodness, we grew up together. We've known each other for years.
No.
I have an idea. Let's do an exercise that's gonna help you trust me.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
Turn around.
Okay.
Face that way.
Okay.
And here's what we're gonna do. You're just gonna fall backwards and you're gonna trust me.
I'm gonna fall backwards and trust you.
You can trust me.
Are you gonna catch me?
Of course I'll catch you. You don't need to worry about that though. All you have to do is trust me. Do you trust me?
Well, I'm really worried about that part about you catching me that you keep saying don't worry about.
Just don't worry about it and just fall backwards. Here we go.
Okay, Miss Summer, I trust you.
Okay, yeah, that didn't quite look like it, did it? I don't think so.
All right.
Here's what we're gonna do. Take a deep breath, and I want you to say out loud, Miss Summer, I trust you.
Okay. Miss Summer, I trust you.
Look at that.
You did it.
I did
it. Caught me.
I caught you. You can trust me.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, so let's do level two.
Level two, baby.
Level two. Okay, all right. Okay, level two. That's not quite level two. Level two is turn around facing me.
All right.
Here we go. All right, level two.
Forward fall.
No. Not a forward fall.
Okay.
All right. Level two, you trust me.
Okay.
You're facing me.
Yes.
I'm right here.
Okay.
And you're gonna fall backwards.
Woo! I don't know if you noticed, but there is nobody back there.
That's okay. There's you just nobody. Trust me. You can just trust me.
No, I can't.
You can trust me.
I really can't. There's no one back there.
You know, sometimes God does the same thing with us. He asks us to do things. He asks us to trust him. We see that all through scripture. And you know, he even did that with Jesus. He asked his son to trust him to die on the cross because God had the perfect plan. And you know what happened? Even though Jesus couldn't see his father, he knew that he had a plan and he trusted him. And when Jesus died, guess what he did? He ran out of the grave. He sure did. And so even when we might not think we can trust God or see him, we can. And so through this skit today and through this song, I want you guys to sing with us about how we can run out of that grave, how Jesus ran out of that grave, okay?
Yeah.
So you guys stand up with us and join us as we sing.
Let's do it.
Till I met Hey, Scottsdale kids, happy Easter. What a beautiful day it is to be alive. And I'm so incredibly excited about sharing God's word with you today. And to tell you the truth, there's no better time to understand who God really is. I've been thinking about a word recently, and that word is a big word, but I know you have bigger brains and can handle it. That word is undefeated. That's right. Let's break it down into its syllables. Undefeated. Undefeated. A team or a person who never loses is called undefeated, right? So let me ask you a question. When you hear this word undefeated, what do you think about? If you play sports, maybe you think about that basketball or soccer team that you dread playing because you know that you're going to get beat when you play them. Or maybe if you think about school, you think about grades and that kid in your class who always seems to get straight A's and never loses at all. Or maybe you play guitar or you sing, you're a musician or you're an artist, and you think about those musicians and those artists who always knock it out of the park or who are set for American Idol. And you think, oh my goodness, they never lose. They're undefeated. Or maybe for all of my video gamers out there, you think about the best gamer you know, and maybe they invite you over to their house, but you say, no, I'm okay. And the reason you say that is because you know they will beat your tail if you go over there. So you don't even go. So they seem to be so undefeated, they always win. When I think about the word undefeated, I think about a man named Michael Phelps. I wonder if you've heard of Michael Phelps. He's an Olympic swimmer, and he has won 28, yes, I'll say it again, 28 Olympic medals. Wow. For years and years, no one could seem to beat Michael Phelps. He was undefeated. So, as we think about the word undefeated, I can't help but think about the Easter story. But to tell you the truth, as we begin the Easter story today, it doesn't always seem like Jesus is undefeated. I mean, Jesus was arrested, and the soldiers beat him and mocked him and made fun of him. That doesn't sound like a winner to me. And then we know that they put a crown of thorns on his head, and we know that they made him carry a wooden cross, and he was hurt all along the way. That sounds like Jesus was being defeated. But this is what we know. When they brought him and they carried him to the cross, and he hung there with nails in his hands and in his feet, something amazing happened. As he was hanging there on the cross, the whole world went dark. And in that moment, Jesus paid for all of your sins, all of the bad things that you thought or said or done. In that moment, Jesus paid for all of them. And that is incredible. So Jesus died on that cross for you. And after he died, they took his body down off the cross and they wrapped him in cloths and they put him in a tomb and sealed it with a heavy stone. Don't you feel like Jesus was defeated? Don't you feel like Jesus has lost? But that's when the story gets amazing. We're going to read a section of scripture that I love so much in this story, and it comes from Matthew chapter 28. Okay, so if you have your Bibles or you can watch along as the words are on the screen, I want us to read from the Word. So, Matthew 28, we're going to read verses 1 through 7. Are you ready? Here we go. Early on Sunday morning, as the new day was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went out to visit the tomb. Suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, rolled aside the stone, and sat on it. His face shone like lightning, and his clothing was as white as snow. The guards shook with fear when they saw him, and they fell into a dead faint. Then the angel spoke to the women, "Don't be afraid," he said. "I know you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He isn't here. He is risen from the dead, just as he said would happen. Come, see where his body was lying. And now go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead, and he is going ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there. Remember what I have told you." So that is the amazing scripture that tells us that Jesus is alive. Not even death could defeat him. No power, no angel, no demon, no person, nothing in all of creation can get in the way of Jesus being a winner. And that is just amazing. But do you know what's the most incredible thing for us when we hear this story? Jesus, the truly undefeated one. There's no one like him. No one compares. Jesus, the undefeated one, wants to have a relationship with you. He wants to be your friend. He loves you, and he died on the cross to show that to you. And that is just incredible to think about. And Jesus being alive, that means that he's beat the greatest enemy, which is death and sin. And so as we think about that, here's the truth. The truth is, the only people that go to heaven are those that have trusted in Jesus, that he died on the cross for their sin, that he was buried in the grave, and that he rose again from the dead on the third day. And those that believe in Jesus and have committed to follow him with their whole life, they get eternal life with Jesus forever. Have you made that decision? If you haven't, today's the perfect day to do so. Talk to your mom and dad or someone in your life that you trust. And I know that once you make that decision to follow Jesus, wow, you will be alive. Because Jesus is alive and because Jesus beat death, so can you. And that is an amazing thing. Who can you share that truth with today, that Jesus is undefeated? Love you guys. I'll see you later. Bye.